Welcome to Decoded by Christina Minutes. Today I'm going to talk about custom properties, also known as CSS variables. Let's get started. Custom properties, also known as CSS variables, can be used to create your very own reusable CSS values. Here's how to use them. Let's say you have specific colors that will be used throughout your website. Instead of trying to memorize the hex values or copying it every time you need it, start by declaring the colors as custom properties. You can name it anything you want, but it must start with a double hyphen. It's also best to give it a descriptive and memorable name. Let's say you have a couple brand colors. You can name it something like brand yellow and brand red, then add a colon followed by the value. In this case, it's the hex values of the two colors. End it with a semicolon. Next, define where the property can be used, usually referred to as the scope. Using the root pseudo class means it can be applied anywhere in the HTML document and to any element. Now that the custom property and scope is defined, it can be used with any CSS property that can accept a color value. But instead of the hex value, use the var function with the custom property name inside the parentheses. I'll set the H2 headings to brand yellow and the paragraphs to brand red. I'll also add a red border to the box div using the brand red variable. The custom properties can be reused throughout your CSS, just like any other value. Let's talk a little bit more about defining the scope. In this example, I have a paragraph and a heading inside and outside of the box div. If I had initially defined the scope using the box selector, it would limit the usage to only the elements contained within the box element. There may be scenarios where you would want to limit the scope, but most of the time, you'll likely be using root. You can always change it later if needed.